Hello and welcome to the non-Greg Stroh's Greg Stroh Show, except only the substitutes. I'm your host, the Pamazon, and I was on the actual Greg Stroh Show as well.
This is the actual show.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
See, it's not, wrong camera. There you go. There you go, Inchmaneer. See, right above my head there, it says the Greg Stroh.
It does say the Greg Stroh Show, yes.
And we are on it Friday nights at 8:30, which is the slot.
The slot. We got the slot.
And who's this?
Hi.
It's the Caped Crusader.
Well, I found this.
Where did you
find that? I dropped somebody off at the McKinley Mall, so I just went in for the heck of it to look around. They had a lot of really cool clothes on sale for like 80% off.
What?
So I got this for like $5.
Because I need more clothes.
Well, we should go
because you already know who I am.
There's this really cool store there that had a bunch of clothes I had never seen, but the really nice quality clothes that was all 80% off. And I thought this was kind of nice for spring because it's not too warm, but it's not like cold either. I don't know. Do you not think it looks nice?
I think it looks nice. I always wear my purse over my shoulder, so I can't wear these because you can't do it with little armholes.
Yeah, but I thought it was for $5. I thought it was really nice.
Oh, geez, yeah, that's pretty.
It was originally $75, and then it was marked down, and then that was marked down to 75% off of that. So there was a lot of clothes on sale at that level. So check out the McKinley Mall. But yeah, I don't know.
I didn't know that place still existed.
It's actually been having a slight resurgence. They went from having no food court to now there was an Indian place. Now there's an Indian place and an Italian place. It's actually there was a new store. It's shockingly they got new owners and they made the rent way cheaper because they just are like slumlords and don't care. But that made it way better because now a bunch of like new things are actually coming out. It's like crazy to see it actually.
So there's these cool weirdo stores.
There is, yeah. Actually, like before there was like this crazy junk store, but that
It closed. Oh, that weird one with
the
lady.
Yeah, the really weird one.
With the weird lady, yes.
Yeah, that one was just like. It was like a downgraded Ambets or something. It was weird. There was crazy stuff in there. But there is another junk store that's a little more expensive. It's not crazy expensive. That's still got a lot of cool stuff. There's been like better stuff in there. For the first time in years, it's actually sort of has life in it. So, yeah, check it out. I don't know. I just like going there because I like the Chinese massage parlor place.
Oh, did you go there?
No, I just wanted to mostly get a drink in the food court, and then I just happened to see these clothes on sale really cheap, and there was other like full-on sweaters and stuff, but I don't have anything like this that's kind of light, so I just figured I'd grab it for like how cheap it was. But I don't know if you don't like it. I mean, I don't have to wear it.
I like it. What did I say against it? I said nothing against it.
Oh, sorry.
Don't be paranoid.
Oh, I'm sorry. But yeah, I don't, it's pretty warm, surprisingly. All I can say is the McKinley Mall is ever so slightly starting to come back. I've told other people this, but like when I was at the video game store across the street, they said their friend was opening up a store there too, so there's probably something else coming as well. You never know. Because I know a bunch of people were upset that it got new owners and they like were just like slumlords who don't care, but that seems like that's helping it, so.
I mean, I do think that malls are exponentially more interesting now. Like, all the weird closed places and then the strange, like, non-corporate places that open up and are way more interesting.
Well, that's the best part. I mean, you know, I've always liked malls. I really did. But it's cooler to have, like, a mix of stuff that is like that, where it's just totally, like, random people just opening their own stores.
I agree.
Because, you know, when I used to talk to this one guy named, I forget, what was his name? Mustafa. And he was telling me about how, like, you know, he had an ice cream store he ran with his mom there, and he was saying how, like, there was just all sorts of, like, weird specific rules he thought was, like, kind of ruining the mall because you had to follow this exact, like, amount, like, ways to, like, place things and the way you placed your sign and, you had to, like, spend a specific amount on a sign, and it was just saying how it was, like, ruining like all the other stores that were trying to open because it's just these rules were just so crazy and they made it way more expensive than it had to be. But assume that's gone now that they have new owners.
Probably.
Yeah, I miss that ice cream place. I still see his mom occasionally, but I don't know. Mustafa. I remember we came up with that song Mustafa's Camel based off of him. It was really bad. It was really dumb. But
no comment.
I mean, all of the songs I ever try to make are either about food or animals.
I know,
much.
You do love animals, it's true.
It's true, I mean, they're so cute, I mean.
You should probably write a song about a giraffe.
You know, that's a great idea. That's a really good idea. I think I should do that, like, all the time. Like, a lot. I remember when we were working on the movie and Greg Sturles, we kind of came up with giraffe candy on the spot, and Greg just thought that was the funniest thing in the world. Because we were like, well, what kind of candy would a giraffe eat? Like, its neck is long and its tongue is huge. It would probably want, like, some kind of jawbreaker that's, like, giraffe-sized. And that's what I imagine it would want, like, because it just licks it all day.
Well, they chew their cud.
Yeah, they do. They're just, like, weird long cows.
Mm-hmm. Lumpy cows.
Yeah. Oh, I remember I was reading something about a giraffe that walked to Paris once, which I just find hilarious. Like, I mean, they can. Like, who's stopping them? They're big. You could just walk there. It'd probably only take you, like, a couple days. I don't know. Who cares? But, yeah, all the things I write for songs are always about either animals or food. Because, I don't know. Why not? That's cute animals are nice. Like, we were doing this one song called Tingaleo about a donkey. And, yeah, I love Tingaleo.
What was the one I played the flute on?
Oh, that was the one about the elephant.
Oh, the elephant.
Yeah.
What was the elephant?
Tantor.
Tantor, okay.
Because that was the name of Tarzan's elephant.
Oh, okay.
Well, that was the name of what Tarzan, in the language of the apes, called elephants. But...
Oh, all right.
If you read the original Tarzan books, which are way better, the movies are pretty fun, but the books are, like, actually good.
I've not read any of the books. I remember watching the movies.
The movies I do enjoy. Remember when it became like when Tarzan goes to the city and they started calling him Jungle Jim?
No.
Those are bad.
I don't think I remember that.
Yeah, it got to a point in the movies where like Jane had like convinced him to like not live in the jungle, and he changed his name to Jungle Jim and he lived in the city. It's really bad.
Well, yeah. I don't even know what it seems like we're like, run out of ideas for the jungle. Let's
think of
some shtick where he goes to the city.
I remember reading that the monkey that played Cheetah was like this huge chain smoker, and he lived a really long time. At least when I was like a kid, he was like still alive. And I just find it hilarious that this monkey was like a chain smoker.
Did he outlive the people in the film?
I think a lot of them.
Yeah.
Yeah,
well, it depends. There was more than one Tarzan, so...
Yeah, there was. Yeah. But it's like how Bubbles is still alive, but Bubbles is crazy now.
Who's Bubbles?
Oh, Michael Jackson's monkey.
Oh, why is Bubbles crazy?
I don't know. Like, they released Bubbles into, like a chimp-like society.
Jesus.
And so Bubbles... You know how, like, Bubbles was always just hanging out with Michael Jackson and just,
yes,
like, basically, like, a child or something? Well, now it just acts like an insane chimp because there was, like, this thing where...
I'm sure it's like, what the fuck?
Yeah. Because Janet Jackson went to see Bubbles recently and she said he was just, like, crazy now.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's not...
Yeah, like, yeah.
Yeah, I mean... I don't know. I can't even think of something. I mean, obviously, you know, that's its native situation or whatever,
well,
but that's not how it was raised or anything.
No, it's not. It's like that one chimp, Amelia, where they raised her like a human just to see what would happen,
mm-hmm,
by that woman and that guy, Jane, which is why is it always Jane with chimps?
Mm-hmm.
Jane Goodall, that Jane with Tarzan. Like, why? But anyway. Yeah, they just raised her completely like a human, and it was, like, weirdly, like, it just did not adapt to it, it did not like it, and it was just, like, I don't know. And then when they released it back into chimp society, it also didn't like that, because it was raised as a human.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, there's a really great video called, Chimp Stories.
Did Did you turn up the volume on the little baby monkey thing I sent you?
Oh, I didn't know there was a volume on it.
Oh, yes.
I thought it was very cute. Oh, actually, yes! Yes, I did! That was so cute! Oh, my gosh. That was so cute. That was adorable. Yeah, monkeys are cool. I used to watch this video called the Monkey Rodeo. We used to always, like, watch these where, like, they would give monkeys, like, bicycles and, like, they would race. It was fun.
What was the secret chimp?
Oh, Lancelot Secret Chimp.
Lancelot Link Secret Chimp.
Yeah, that show's crazy. That's, like, one of the best like, I can't even imagine how... I think it said it was, like, a bunch of people who worked on Carol Burnett who wanted to, like, make it a segment on that show, but she didn't want it, so they just made it their own show. Which is kind of even better, because, it's like, that's literally... Like, what... Who is, like, in TV, like, executive lands, like, yeah, that's great, guys. Like, I'm glad they did, but... How do you even, like... How do you train a bunch of chimps to, like, do that? Although it said on the Wikipedia that they just, like, gave them some crazy clothes and just filmed them doing whatever and then made up a story out of it.
Yeah, I read that too.
I don't know how Jane Goodall hangs out with chimps. Chimps seem like the scariest of all animals. Like, it's just like an insane guy that's so jacked and huge and, like, just will go insane at any moment. Like, why does she live with them? Like,
well,
I always
liked...
Well,
they never hurt her, right? Or at least
they
not
don't,
seriously.
But, like...
If she did get hurt.
I'd be terrified. Like, you can't just live with chimps. Like, how? What are you gonna do?
Well, Jane Goodall did. I don't know about you, buddy.
I know she still does. But she's, like... It's just, like, mind-blowing. Like, why would you ever decide to, like, live with a chimp? Like, chimps are crazy. Andy used to always get mad at me, but I'd way rather hang out with a bear than a chimp.
Well,
chimps are insane.
I mean, bears can hurt you, too, you know?
Bears are, like, scary. Andy would always be like, yeah, but they have, like, literal knives for fingers. Like, a chimp, I feel like it could talk to it. It's like, yeah.
Talk to it? Listen, Harry, just calm down.
Like, because it's, like, basically just a guy, like, but...
I think bears are super cute.
Yeah, bears are cute, and it seems like they, like, I don't know, chimps just always seem like they're so angry. Or, like, and if they want something, they'll just literally, like, tear it apart. Like, chimps are insane. It's not like the bonobos, where at least they're nice sometimes.
But you can, can't you just, well, they can't swim, though, right?
I don't know. I don't want to watch, I want to see a chimp try and swim.
Because I think they
swim.
Don't have enough body fat to float at all.
Probably.
Those go cold.
Because they're just... cute. They're just massive.
I need to look that up. Is that an urban myth?
I don't know.
I think they can.
I mean, that doesn't seem like it makes any sense, because then wouldn't just, like, really muscular people not be able to swim?
I remember trying to teach my friend to swim, who was very thin. Well, trying to teach him even to float, and he was very thin. He didn't have any body fat, and he could not float. He just kept going, honk.
No, I can't swim.
I'd be like, no, just lay on your back.
I don't know. I just... Yeah, chimps seem really scary.
Let's see. Can they swim?
I would imagine yes.
Huh.
Yeah, I would imagine they could. It doesn't seem... I don't see why they couldn't. I mean...
Since they don't.
Oh, they don't. Oh, never mind. I'm wrong. Whatever. Well, fine. If I need to escape from a chimp, even though I can't swim, I feel like I'd still be better in some water.
You can't swim?
I can't swim at all.
Really?
Oh, God, it's so hard.
Wait, can you float?
No, and not at all. I mean, I can swim if I, like, paddle as hard as I possibly can.
Here's one that can swim.
Oh, okay, good.
So a few here and there can swim.
If I paddle as hard as possible, I can do it ever so slightly and go very, very not far at all, but it's not anywhere close to good.
A few can swim.
Trust chimps, they're crazy. Like, I like them, but I don't want to hang out with them. Like, why does Jane Goodall want to hang out with a chimp? Like, I'd rather hang out with something nice, like a cat.
Cats have literal knives for fingers.
Yeah, but they at least, like, you know, you can, like, explain it to them, and they'll be nice.
Yeah, so some of them can swim.
I'd way rather, I mean, if you'd rather be with a chimp than a cat, then I don't get it, but, like...
But not, they're like not great swimmers, so. But, I mean, you just said you can't swim, so I guess that's not a plan.
No. I mean, I feel like
during
I'd
your
hang
chimp,
out with a
tiger. During your inevitable chimp attack. Tigers, you're screwed. They can climb, they can swim, they can run faster,
yeah,
they can do
tigers,
all the things better than you.
They at least seem like nice people. Like, I feel like you could talk to one. I feel like you could explain to it and it might calm down.
I don't think it will.
Well, I like to imagine it did.
I think you were wrong.
It depends on the kind of tiger. Like, if you get those huge Bengali tigers, but if you get a nice little golden tiger, or if you get one of those, like, Persian tigers, they seem more friendly.
So you're saying you want a chimp before a bear, right?
No, I'd rather hang out with a bear.
You want the bear, okay.
Chimps are insane. Like, they're just, like, the most aggressive, insane, like, person ever.
I mean, bears are tough, too, because they can also run, climb, and swim.
Yeah, but again, I feel like you could talk to a bear and it'll at least, like, calm down. Like, if you're nice to it. I don't trust any of them. I'd rather... I was just trying to think of my animal songs. Let's see. I've got Tingaleo the donkey. I've got the elephant song. I've got many giraffe songs. I've got the cat song. Most of the songs are always about animals. That's...
Okay.
I don't know. They're just cute. I don't think I have any songs about a dog. But I've got some songs. I don't know. I mean, I had that one song called Johnny the Monkey. Yeah, I don't know. That's pretty much...
Johnny the Monkey?
Yeah.
I'm on here.
Yeah, all the songs are, like... It's always the same two themes. It's animals and food. Like, I'm trying to think of ones that I came up with that aren't, like... Very few.
Here we go.
Very few. I know you can't see it, but it's a tiny monkey making bird sounds. Oh, it's so cute. You guys gotta look up tiny monkey with bird sound. Oh, it's a great video. You gotta look it up. I don't know. Yeah.
Look, it's so cute, John.
I can't look. We're on the show. I get very excited by the cute monkeys, but I don't know why. Yeah, the monkey rodeo. There was this great video where, like, you would see this monkey on a tiny little motorcycle, and it would go around and, like, pickpocket people and go to this, like, Indian guy. It was crazy. It was just like this. It was like in India, and like this guy had trained his monkey to like go on a tiny motorcycle and pickpocket people. And he was showing how he did it, like, and nobody noticed. Cause who expect? Okay, who's just walking around and expects a monkey to go by on a motorcycle and like rob you?
Not me.
I wouldn't expect that at all. Like,
I don't expect that.
I mean, I'd honestly be just kind of like excited. Like, if I got robbed by a monkey.
I've weirdly never seen a bear in the wild, although we have seen a bobcat, so.
Bears seem like they kind of stay away for the most
part.
But
it seemed like, people in Genesee County were hitting them, you know, they were getting hit in the road like deer for a while, and I never saw one.
I've never seen one. My grandmother saw one once, and she lived out in the country for, like, her entire life and lived up until, like, she was over 100, and she'd only ever seen a bear the one time. It was, like, a few years before she died. So, I don't know. I think maybe... I don't know. I guess it just depends. We've only got the brown bears, right? Or the black bears?
I think the black bears, yeah.
Yeah, because there's, like...
They're... Well, in Dansville, like, they're having trouble where they'd get in their... The big... You know, the big industrial dumpsters? Like, people come out and open the dumpsters. Open the lid, and there's a bear, like... Shit. Sitting in there because the lid fell shut on
bears
it.
Bears are just so cute, though.
Or baby bears, which I'm just like, I cannot imagine how excited I'd be if there was baby bears.
I know, they
door.
Are cute.
Like, oh my god, baby bears.
I like pandas, too, but pandas are like the weirdest bear.
But I don't know what you would do with baby bears, because if the mom's around, that's the one time that they would get aggressive.
Yeah, they'd get mad. You can't convince them.
Yeah,
then.
Yeah. You can't really, I don't know. I don't know what I'd do. With baby bears, other than go, oh my god, baby bears.
They're cute though. I do.
So yeah, I think it was weird that we saw bobcat because I think they're way more rare.
New York's wildcats in general, like, they're here, but you don't really see them.
It was so weird too because it was like jumping straight up, and then all of a sudden it jumped up and went like, woof, and then it jumped back up, and I was trying to figure out what it was. And, like, the first thing that came to my mind was kangaroo. I'm like, but we don't have kangaroos. What is that?
I don't know. It's a giant jackrabbit.
It's a giant cat. And then the people, like, there was actually a house where it was, and the dog was like, rawr, 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 I'm going to get you. I'm like, no, dog, you are not. You are not going to get the cat. That will not happen, sir.
No.
That cat will destroy you.
Didn't you see that video of the dog defending his owner from the bear?
Oh, I did, yeah. That's... Bears are... Dogs are crazy then. Don't... I don't know. I mean, I guess they are just so crazy, like...
I've seen cats... Videos of cats chasing off bears.
Oh, I'm sure they do, too.
Cat's going at the bear's like, what? What? Oh my god, what the? This thing's nuts! I'm out of here!
Because let's face it, like, even if the bear knows it could win, like, why would it even bother? Because the cat's so crazy, it's gonna mess it up to some degree, even if it does.
That is good bear reasoning.
So, like, I'm just gonna, I don't even wanna deal with you. I don't wanna deal with you. Like, get out of here. But, yeah, I don't know. It reminds me of. I don't know what it reminds me of. I was gonna say. Say a dog, but a nice.
Although I've
dog.
Seen other videos, of people like were in their houses and bears just like freaking broke right in.
Oh, I've seen that too.
I yeah, it's crazy. It was like bam.
Because they're just like giant. Yo, like
I'm in your house.
I don't know. It's weird because like a weird thing about pandas is there's no documentation or pictures of them at all in any Chinese writing. Isn't that crazy? Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And no one knows why.
Huh.
Like, you can look it up. There is, like, one example of some Chinese, like, emperor or something giving a panda pelt to someone, but it's, like, the only time it's ever referenced.
Hmm.
And nobody knows why. Which, it seems weird. It's like, are pandas some kind of weird conspiracy or something? Like,
well, like, the Museum of Science here has that big stuffed grizzly bear.
Oh, yeah, it does. And oh, it's cool when you're at the Smithsonian, they have that taxidermy blue whale. That's crazy.
Oh, jeez. That's got to be huger.
It's massive, but it's gone now, sadly.
Oh, what happened to it?
Well, I mean, I went there when I was, like, 18, and then we went back when I was, like, 24 or something. But they said it's just people kept throwing stuff at it, so they had to put it in the back.
Why would they throw stuff at it?
I don't know.
Let's go to the museum and throw stuff at the whale. What? These are people desperate for some real entertainment.
The Smithsonian is like one of the coolest places I've ever seen. Like the Hope Diamond freaked me out so bad. Like I just didn't even want to get close to it.
Oh, because of the bad luck?
Because of all the weird curses and stuff. I was like, I don't want to get close to this thing. I don't trust it. I don't want to be near you. I don't know. Yeah, that taxidermied whale was pretty cool though. There's so many weird... I love watching videos where, like, they talk about, like, weird creatures that have washed up on, like the from the ocean and nobody knows what they are. Like for, like, years, they had never found, like, an actual colossal squid alive, but now they've found, like, one or two.
How big is a colossal squid?
They're, like, as long as a blue whale, but, like, since most of it's their tentacles, like, they're huge. Like, because they kept finding, like, whales that would wash up with, like, they were fighting them. So they're, like, basically, like, you know, just the size of a whale. Imagine a squid that huge.
I'm just wondering what happened, what transpired, you know, that the whale and the squid decided to battle it out.
Yeah, they say it's common that whales and those kind of squids fight, like, all the time.
Do they eat them?
I don't know. I have no idea. I just know it's common that whales and those gigantic squids will fight.
Huh,
and then
okay.
Another cool story is the loneliest whale. There's this one whale that
sounds
has...
sad.
It's that no one knows why, and they've never been able to find it, only they can hear it by its voice. That it's got... It's calls out into the world, and it's got a very specific frequency, so no other whales can hear it. And they've been tracking it since, like, the late 80s, and it just constantly calls out it with its whale song, but it's on a frequency that other whales can't hear. And they don't know if it's some rare species or something.
Huh.
So look up the loneliest whale. You can hear its voice. It's really pretty.
Oh,
you know, the funniest thing. You know that Russian radio station that's, like, haunted?
No, what?
Well, anyway, this is
what
funny.
What do you mean, anyway?
You know,
okay,
no. You know
the
that
buzzer?
One? Yeah, the buzzer.
You're talking about the buzzer?
I was listening to it the other day when we were trying to go to sleep, and somebody hacked it and was playing all this, like, ridiculous music. They were playing, like, the Macarena and songs from, like, the Madagascar movies and the Shrek theme song.
Oh, no.
And then, like, all this crazy stuff, and they were playing, like, Pee Wee Herman voice clips. And then I heard like a Russian voice, like, and all of a sudden it went back to the regular buzzer. It was so crazy. I couldn't even believe I caught it when they were like, somebody hacked it and was playing all those ridiculous songs.
Why is it haunted, though?
Listen to it. Look it up. The buzzer is creepy as heck. Nobody knows where it's broadcasting from.
Oh.
Why?
Russia.
It's Russian. They can track it to Russia. And it's been broadcasting since like the late 50s. And it just keeps
early
making...
80s.
Is it the early 80s? I thought
early
they had...
Early 80s.
Okay, I'm sorry. Well, I knew it was something. But anyway, yeah, it just makes these weird, constant buzzing sounds. But every once in a while, it'll be interrupted by like...
Numbers
and Russians, random Russian phrases.
Oh, that's a number station then, right?
Yes.
It is, yeah, but this one, there's like a story to it for why it's particularly like creepy. But I just thought it was so funny that I listen to it sometimes when I'm trying to go to sleep, and somebody had hacked it and was playing like ridiculous like movies, music, and just like sound clips.
Huh.
Yeah, look up the buzzer. You can listen to it like 24 hours a day on YouTube or...
So there's still number stations going at it.
At least that one. I know about number stations, but I think there's something to this one that makes it particularly creepy. I could be wrong, but I thought I heard that there
it's
was...
It's probably just the buzzing.
Yeah, probably.
Well, I guess in some ways, number stations... I don't know.
But yeah, look up
the
buzzer.
Maybe they're more autonomous.
It's...
I remember when I worked this place and I was moved to another... client, and it was the government, and they're like, the internet was pretty new, and they're like, well, you know, we can't, you know, we can't track the internet. That's what they said. We can track the mail, but we can't track the internet. And I was like, wait a minute here, you're telling me, and this is before people really knew much about the internet, I'm like, you're telling me the 90s, you're telling me you can't track the internet. Nope, we can't track the internet. I was like, I don't believe you. Like, well, we can't. And I'm like, I think you're lying. They got really mad at me.
Well, can
and
you?
Then I had to leave the meeting.
Can you not track it? I mean, I would assume you can't just because of the dark web and stuff.
I mean, there wasn't any dark web then, really. I don't think.
I don't know. I would just assume because all the dark web is just like not unclassified, but filialized internet. Like, because that's where lots of people buy, like, drugs, and you can buy, like, Hitman and stuff. If you go on, like, Tor or Onion. But, I was always too scared.
They just weren't the same. Like,
I don't really know. I know nothing about it, so you'd know more than me. I was just guessing. I was just wondering. I don't know.
They were like, oh, we can track the mail, though. I'm like, give me a break. Like, someone could send a letter anywhere. You wouldn't know where to look. And you
yeah.
can't see inside it. You're lying.
I didn't even question that. Yeah, you're right. It seems harder to track physical mail.
Like, you're lying.
Yeah,
I got so mad. I got kicked out of the meeting.
For what? Where was it trying to work? You said the government? What kind of
I worked at SoftBank, Client Logic, UCNL.
Well, morons run things, you know.
I also got kicked out of the Windows 95 launch, which I've told that story before, so. The Windows 95 launch training, yeah.
Windows 95.
But they really, like, needed people, so I never got fired or anything. Also, I just did it very, like, naively most times, you know? I wasn't trying to be a menace. I got a big mouth, I guess.
Yeah, I don't know. I was trying to look at the Windows laptops today, but they're so pricey. But I don't know.
The Windows laptop? What?
Oh, I was just trying to look at the Windows laptops.
Drifted.
And then, but then I saw a bunch of them on like Craigslist, really cheap, and it was an iPad for like $50. So I don't know.
What do you want to do?
Oh, I was just looking.
Oh, okay.
Just because my old laptop that I had, it's not broken, but it won't charge. So I don't know. I just wish my old one would work, but the charger, the port broke.
The port?
Yeah.
That can probably be replaced. I mean, how old is it, though?
I bought it in, like, 2015.
That's kind of old.
Yeah, it was really good. It wasn't technically a laptop. It was a tablet with a laptop attachment.
Oh, okay.
That functioned like a laptop. It was just nice, but...
Was it, like, the one May had?
It was very similar. But but bigger. Anyway, who cares?
Yes.
Goodbye. Check out the buzzer, people.